see. Oh, better than lie to me. That's when I bless you. My lips shall praise you.
Much better than life to me, and all the days of my life I'll do well in your house, and all mercy and goodness will follow me. All the days of my life I will dwell in your house, and your goodness and mercy will follow me. All the days of my life I'll do well in your house, your goodness and mercies will follow me. All the days of my life I do well in your house, and your goodness and mercies will follow me. Oh Lord, all the days of my life I will dwell in your house, and your goodness and mercy shall follow me. from on high has visited me. He's poured out this life and he's given me thus my lips shall praise thee. Thus will I bless thee. Hallelujah. Ha ha ha. Woo! Yeah! Santa Kaya! Santa Petorama! Say it for my say up, say a brava, say a little soto, your robot so. Say every Monday of my car. My eternal life. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. My abundant life. Hallelujah. Oh, oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus, my inheritance. Oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus, my inheritance. Katoyana. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. My abundant life. Yeah. Oh, my abundant life. My inheritance. Oh, come on now. Somebody put a microphone in front of that girl. Ha, hallelujah, hallelujah, mana. Oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus. My inheritance, my inheritance, my inheritance. Oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus, oh, Lord Jesus, my inheritance, my abundant life, oh, Lord Jesus, oh, my inheritance. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. My inheritance. My inheritance. My eternal life. Well, you might as well get ready because God's going to use you in a big way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We've come here tonight to speak into your life, to let the power of God shape you. Hallelujah. You're not a wood carving. Hallelujah. You're not a straw man. You're not something made of the earth. But you're something that's got to be heated up real hot to be shaped. Ha sabakata yaha. Ha. Something like gold, something like silver. So if it gets hot in here, just hang on. Strap yourself down. Doesn't matter how intense it is, how hard it is for you to hear, how challenging it is. God's word comes to give you power and strength and ability. I'm telling you right now, sometimes the more challenging it is for you to hear, the greater result God produces in your life if you're willing to participate. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus, my inheritance. Come on, Deborah. My inheritance. Oh, oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. My inheritance. My eternal life. My eternal life. My abundant life. Oh, my abundant life. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Well, I'm going to just tell you right now, God charted His church and meant for His church to continually operate and function and be. I reckon we need a new microphone. God ordained this church and started this church in the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the expression of the Spirit of the living God. Issuing out of our innermost being. And then out of that comes now the prayer of understanding also. And out of that comes the singing also. We want to have it a different way. We want to chart our own course and think that we're going to meet up with God at the end of the road. Or along the way. It ain't going to happen. You're walking diametrically opposed to God unless the Holy Spirit is leading you, because Father's not taking a couple of different routes. He doesn't have choice A, B, and C. It's just A. It's narrow. It's very, very strict. Hallelujah. And few be there that find it. But anybody who reads the word and calls upon the name of the Lord, they're in. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 And Father, I thank you that you've taken a hold of my very being, my body, which is your house, my spirit, which is joined unto you. My life, O God, which is purchased by you and belongs unto you, and that you've raised me up for such a time as this. O God, not to sit back and just let things be as they are, but to rise up in your divine power and authority and change it according to your will and your word. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And for those of you who didn't know, what we just did is we prayed in the Spirit so that we could pray with the understanding also. That's what we just did. Hallelujah. It's good. It works a lot better than all those other kinds of prayers. And we sang in the Spirit, and then we sang with the understanding also. And what happens is the more that God's people are committed to this, the stronger the display of God's presence and power. Hallelujah. I want you to grab a hold of the things of the Spirit of God so the display of the Spirit of the Lord becomes so powerful in your life that there is no containing it. Amen. Anymore. Hallelujah. You can be seated. I'll spend a little time just encouraging you tonight. Once again, I am just so blessed for everybody who... I'm glad that you're here tonight, but I'm just so blessed for everybody who came and comes to the School of the Spirit. Because it's a great testimony when you come to the School of the Spirit. It means that you want to be in it. Hallelujah. And so those of you that couldn't make it because you had more important things to do, you had already scheduled your life, we do have it on YouTube. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And I know some of you stay at home like my wife and watch on the YouTube and you're totally plugged in. That's fine too. But I want you to get into it, because the fact of it is the Father wants to show you and me how to move with Him. And these things aren't very difficult. It's all based around a relationship with Him where you come to enjoy His presence.
where His presence becomes bigger to you and your love relationship with Him is bigger to you than anything else that's going on, so that you're so filled up with Him, you don't have room for anything else. Amen. Then you quit worrying about who loves you. They love me, they love me not, they love me, they love me not. You're always stopping on the love me nots. Huh? And all you now are, you just got all the love you could possibly ever have, and all you're interested in is loving people. Hallelujah. It ain't about how, whether anybody loves you, never even noticed. You're so saturated in love. People who are always having somebody to say, you know, oh, there's not enough love around there. That is one hurting person. One hurting person. And good news tonight, if you're one of those hurting persons, if you're one of those hurting persons like a missing person, if you're one of those, the love of God is here. The love and the power of God is here to be poured into you by the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And then there's a continual supply, but you've got to learn how to enjoy His life. I think that one of the most sorrowful things is people walking around here in the realms of heaven, in the realms of the holies of holies, all bummed out in the kingdom of God. It is just so sad, and it's just because of the cares. It's because of the cares, the riches, and pleasures, the CRP. And I hope you get out of the CRP in Jesus' mighty name. Get out of the cares and riches and pleasures, which will choke the word so that it cannot produce and bring forth the fruit the Father's purposed to happen in your life. So I'm going to talk to you tonight about an increase in the anointing and an increase in the display of the power of God in your life. And people talk about an increase in the anointing, and many people don't know what they're asking. What you're actually asking God to do is that the Lord Jesus Christ would be revealed through your life with greater display of His life and power. Hallelujah. Yeah,
hallelujah.
You know, people are like all mealy-mouthed and concerned when they try to say, I no longer live, it's Christ, because they've got it wrong. They've got it all wrong in their thinking. You've got to get it big in your thinking, like, I've received the life of God. This life
yes.
is so great. This
Hallelujah.
Life is so wonderful. And see, now you've found the pearl of great price. Now you've got a treasure that you've discovered that's hidden in the field, and you're not going and trying to sell all that you have to get something that you've never seen. Are you listening to
yes.
me? See, when all of a sudden you're just captivated, you're just caught away, that I've received the life of Jesus, I have the life of Christ, I have the life of God, I have the life of the Spirit, then it's no problem to say, hey, and I no longer live, get out of here, I don't even want that, you know? I mean, I hate my life in this world compared to this life I got over here. Woo, God gave me an exchange, my goodness, hallelujah. This is the exchange rate in the kingdom of God, hallelujah. I mean, it's a premium. I'm telling you, you come turn yourself in, get God. Hallelujah. And if we could just get God's people to come to understand that this is not the place of the transgressor, which is hard, but this is the place of, this is the burden-free zone. This is the glorious life zone. Hallelujah. This is the glorious liberty of the sons of God. Hallelujah. This is the place where you go out rejoicing, go forth in peace, and the mountains and the hills break forth into singing. Hallelujah. And all the trees of the fields start going, woo! I start clapping their hands. Here comes the sons of God. Woo! Here comes the sons of Mositai, of the Molapai. Here comes the sons of the Most High, the ones bought by the blood of Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Amen. So, if you've never been here before, I'm just in and out of tongues and interpretation tongues all the time. And because this is the way we live. This is who we are. We are the people of the new covenant. I am a person of the new covenant. I've been baptized in the Holy Ghost with the experience and expression of the tongues of fire, where there is prophecy, tongues, interpretation of tongues. We're going to give you knowledge and revelation tonight, doctrine and prophecy. Praise God. Hallelujah. A couple people happy. A few people shocked. Some people already got your safety belts on because you know how bad it can get in here, huh? Hallelujah. For me, it's all good. Hallelujah. When you begin to realize that the church is the fullness of Him that fills all things, and it is very upsetting to the Holy Ghost that we would be willing to accommodate something less. It is very upsetting to God that we would be willing to accommodate something less. The church is the fullness of Him that filleth all things, and it's upsetting to God that we would accommodate something less, that we would take His glory and change it into something that looks like a four-footed beast. Mm-hmm. Amen. Or even a man. Sometimes I think four-footed beasts do better than men. But praise God, you know, we don't have to live like men anymore. Huh?
Yes.
So now some of you staring at me like that, you just don't even know. You don't know. You don't realize that you became a part of a new race, that you were begotten of God, begotten of the Word, begotten of the Spirit. You became a new creation, a new creature, a possessor of the divine nature, the very temple and tabernacle of the Most High God, where Jesus Christ tabernacles on the inside of you. You're the temple of the Holy Ghost. Is that living like a mere man?
No.
Oh, yeah, I know why it's getting so quiet in here. Because the human mind and effort and ability can't reach unto it. Oh, no, and so it's intimidating, it's scary when God says, be holy even as I am holy. It's an excitement to me because it's an empowerment, it's a gift that God gave me that I can be taught and grow and mature in, that I can have. Until you get past condemnation and shame and guilt, and the miracles and the signs and wonders begin to take place. Hallelujah. Ha ha. Ha. To be, I'm righteous even as He is righteous.
What?
The good.
Yeah.
I'm righteous even as He is righteous. Huh? I'm righteous as even as He is righteous. And most people go, what? You got to be kidding me. That sounds like heresy. No, that sounds like the Bible to me. 1 John chapter 3, verse 7. He that does righteous is righteous even as He is righteous. And he that sins is of the devil. People don't want it come down like that. They do not want it to be that plain, that clear, that much truth versus lie, that much God versus Satan, that much darkness versus light. This is the way it is, and I'm so excited about it personally. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, I'm so blessed that I belong 100% to God, and the devil can't access me. You know, you don't have to wait till 1 second after you die to realize how beautiful this is, how powerful it is, how much God has claimed you, how much you belong to Him, how much you are free from the power of sin and death. Hallelujah. How much God has taken a hold of you and called you His purchased possession and put within your very bones resurrection life. Every one of my cells are dancing right now with resurrection life. They all just... Hallelujah. Father wants you to understand how to enjoy His presence so His glory touches every part of your being, especially your emotions and your passions. Aristotle didn't like that. Socrates didn't like that. Plato didn't like that, and all those other nutcases that came in and indoctrinated the church in the 3rd and 4th century with their polluted doctrines and ideologies. But I'm going to tell you right now, this is where the river flows, through your emotions and through your passions. And when God's moving through His rivers are moving through your emotions and through your passions with all these holy emotions and with all these holy passions, Satan doesn't have a chance. With bringing his stuff out of the garbage can, you know, it's the bum that hasn't taken a bath in several years, bringing the garbage can over to your life for breakfast and saying, what would you like? He goes, I've already eaten, man. I'm sitting at the table of the master. Hallelujah. They think it's so hard to live free from sin. No, it's not. You just get over in the glory. My goodness, you can't even think about it. You know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Halakana jambaya. You fall so in love with His glory and with His presence, you do not want anything to compromise that. You're so shocked and overwhelmed by the miracles and signs and wonders. I was saying this morning, I was just talking about different people who healed, radical miracles. We were talking about a person who received a new heart, who had a pacemaker and their heart was still not even working. And they got received a new heart in the meeting. Somebody recently posted, it happened 6 years ago. They're sitting at the meeting and they got a new heart. And the doctors recently closed their case and said unexplainable. You don't need a pacemaker, you got a new heart. And I was talking about how some girl had been healed, had been prayed by so many people. She was deaf and right or left ear, I can't remember. And the Lord just healed her in the meeting. And then a person just started saying, hey, just when I was here the second time, I was deaf in one ear. Where is she? She's not here tonight? If you're watching my web, we love you. That's amazing. I'm just always excited about the miracles of God because it's just, that's the way it is. The more time you spend in His presence, you see His signs and wonders. You see the exploits of the fact that He exists, that He's here. Hallelujah, that He exists and that He's here. Say, He exists.
He exists.
And He's here.
He's here.
Hallelujah. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Listen, without faith, it is impossible to please God, and those that are in the flesh can't please Him either. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Those that are in the flesh cannot please God. But brethren, you not in the flesh, but in the Spirit. Amen. I just quoted Romans 8:8 and 8:9 in part. Hallelujah. But without faith, it is impossible to please God. It's the new creation. It's the new man. It's the new creature. It's the one that Jesus Christ reproduced in our lives when we became citizens of heaven, part of the family of God. Hallelujah. When a new race was born, when we were born of the Spirit, when Jesus Christ opened up the door at Calvary's cross, when he went down into hell for 3 days, rose up from the third day, and then ascended up on high, led captivity captive, hallelujah, was exalted right hand of the Father and poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pray that every one of you just have that much of a testimony and message to go everywhere and preach the gospel. Watch what's going to happen, because Father is going to explode on the scene. He is dedicated to glorifying his only begotten Son, and one of the premier ways in which Jesus Christ is glorified in us is because we ask Father things and he answers us. We have a relationship that is quantifiable, where we ask and he does the work. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Ha tokoda naste. Ha mandeya. Oh, koste. Ambeleka. We'll take you, if you'll just do it, do that more, participate with that more, we'll take you over into a realms of the depth of glory. People just sometimes, they just only begin to move with God. They get in, not even ankle deep. They just get the soles of their feet wet, and they just think, well, that's good enough. I put in my time. I got other things to do. And then they go off back into the cares, riches, and pleasures, the issues of their own life, the self-interest. And they miss out on what it means to just take a hold of the things of the Spirit of God and begin to press in. Begin to go deeper and deeper. And the more time you spend with the Lord and just loving on him, not getting all, you know, whipped out of shape through all your concerns and issues and crying out and whatnot, but you just begin to let the Spirit of the living God flow through you. The Spirit of the Lord will take over you. It will not exhaust you. It will refresh you. Somebody said, I talk too fast. Well, just get over in the realm to the Holy Ghost. I'll be talking too slow. I'm telling you, it's a whole other realm. It's a whole other dimension. I'm going to tell you right now, if you say I talk too fast, oh, I don't go to the church over there, he talks too fast. You know what? If I slowed down, it'd be still too fast for you, because you're going to come out of that realm, that earthly, sensual, selfish realm, over into this place we're living in, the God realm. God is here to teach you how to live in his realm. He's here to teach you how to live in his glory, how to walk in his ways. He gave you the gift of righteousness, and he gave you the gift of holiness so that you would be able to be mentored by the Holy Spirit himself in it. Yeah. Hallelujah. This is the covenant. This is the deal. The Lord said, I'm going to give you my holiness and I'm going to give you my righteousness, and you've got to be willing now to be taught and matured and instructed in it. That's the covenant. Hallelujah. Harabah. People are always trying to get holy, always trying to get righteous, always trying to get undone. That's not in the faith. That's not part of the Son. The faith that is impossible without, that is impossible to please God unless you have it, is the new creation. It's not all these other things. That is the faith. The faith is to be born again. It's the new creation. Circumcision, uncircumcision doesn't matter to God. What matters to God is a new creation, someone born of the Spirit. You can't even come into this realm, understand this realm, relate to this realm. This realm is entirely foolish to you and foreign to you until you're born of the Spirit. Hallelujah. Now, once having been born of the Spirit, when you were born in this life, you were born in sin, and every day you were shaped to be just like the devil. I'll say it again. When you came into this life, you were born in sin, and every day you were shaped in iniquity. You were shaped in anomia, which means lawlessness. It is an expression of the attributes and nature of the satanic. But when you were born again, you were born in righteousness to be every day shaped in holiness. Hallelujah. Ha ha ha. Hallelujah. To be taught by the Holy Ghost how to behave and act just like Father. To walk as God's covenant people, and those who learn to make the same kind of choices that he makes, to have the same kind of compassion for people that he has, to fully represent him as those who are his sons and his daughters, family members that aren't just like children that differ nothing from a servant, but those who are sons, the sons that has stepped in to the ministry of the Father. And when you read Galatians chapter 4, there's no other way to understand it. I hear people always talking and always living, as it were, like that there are children under the law, under tutors and mentors until the acceptable day. And as such, they differ nothing more than a servant, and they live in the struggles and the bondage of human ability, which can never please God. Hallelujah. People, many times they hear all these wonderful things that God says, be pure even as I'm pure. Hallelujah. And they get all upset. Be perfect even as I am perfect. And they get all upset. They go to try to get a consultant who's a theologian. They hear, be holy even as I'm holy. Hallelujah. Because as he is, so are we in this world, that we live in him and walk in him, that as many as are led by the Spirit, that move in the Spirit, to walk in the Spirit. And they become overwhelmed. They say, how can I do it? Because they look to the self. They look to the human ability. It's the conceited legalism of an unredeemed mind. Oh, it's the kingdom of God. But when you grab a hold of the Word of God, a wellspring of faith will begin to rise up, and you'll say, I can because he made me so. Hallelujah. I can go because he's empowered me to do all these things. I found myself undone and unclean, and something more than a seraphim grabbed a hold of a coal from off of the altar. God Almighty took on the robes of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh, and brought and purged me with his own blood. Not a seraphim with a coal from off the altar saying your sin is taken away and is purged. But the Almighty God himself with his own blood redeemed you and me. Come on, people. It's about time we get out of a defiled conscience and get over in here into a place of enjoying his presence. You can't enter into this realm. You cannot enter into this realm with a defiled conscience. You're just standing out in the court of the Gentiles. You're going to have to come into a place where you just accept that what grace has done for you, what the blood has done for you, and begin to rejoice in God for what Christ Jesus did for you when you were made a new creation, and just begin to prophesy over yourself and rejoice in it and run off every opposing thought by the rejoicing of it, by the praising of it. People sit around and have dinner with condemnation. They have breakfast with shame. They have lunch with guilt. They go out on the town, with sense of separation, communing all the time with these demons of hell, and wonder why they can't move into this glory realm. You're going to have to learn that the regenerated mind, that is the mind of Christ, that is the mind of the Spirit, is the mind that meditates upon his word day and night. Hallelujah. It's the mind that thinks according and processes everything about your life according to what God's word describes of us. You understand? And then in this regenerated mind, not an unregenerated mind, but in this regenerated mind, we have to stand up and take the weapons of our warfare, which are not carnal, but mighty through God, or God power. And we're going to have to cast down imaginations. We have to bring into captivity every thought to the obedience of Jesus Christ, to the obedience of the knowledge of God. Hallelujah. 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 Every thought that opposes the knowledge of God and the obedience of Jesus Christ. Because that's who he is. It's who he's made us. I no longer live. Praise God. Amen. I can say it like this and be perfectly accurate. Christ Jesus is the one who lives. I no longer live. And I really believe it would help people, if they would address him first and themselves last. Because it's just like you get stuck. I no longer live. And it's almost hard to get to the point that, but Christ lives in me. But if you could just take a hold of the life of God tonight, just learn how easy it is, how wonderful it is. Hallelujah. 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 How easy it is. Hango domon desteya. We're getting ready to do Havana, Cuba's first crusade. Now, that's just miracle stuff, Only God can do that. Somebody said, how did you do that? How did you get that? Standing in his presence, getting excited about it, dancing around. That's how. Jesus said, really? Yeah, really. That's where the power and the glory of God begins to be made manifest. Not through all the networking, not through all the human ability. We're getting ready to do the greatest thing that's ever happened in the nation of Cuba. This year, later this year, Havana, Cuba. I'm just believing God that Castro will be on the platform. We had it set up in 2001, late 2001, that Saddam Hussein was going to be on the platform in the crusade in Baghdad, Iraq. And governments came in and messed that up, but we're going to come back to it. But now we'll get up. I want to get into these places. Father just opening these doors, Praise God. Isn't Father wonderful? Yeah. Isn't he wonderful? Yeah. Just amazing. Everybody was all upset because Obama, he got in there and he betrayed all the conservatives and removed the embargo, while the rest of us in the crying church of Cuba was going, woo! Why? Because we knew it was an open door. We knew the embargoes come down. It's an open door. We can go in. Friendly relationships have begun. Oh, the church walking around. You need to get into the things of the Spirit. You are actually called to go and preach the gospel to every creature. You're supposed to go and lay down your life. Somebody said, oh, we got to shut the borders because ISIS is going to come in. Let them all come in. Let's have an outpouring of the Holy Ghost. Let them all get saved. Because you either going to bring them here or you got to go there. Which one are you going to do? I just assume they all come here because I'm tired of flying. I'm tired of flying. We're getting ready to take off. We go to Norway, and from Norway, then we go to southern India, about 3 miles outside of Hyderabad. Oh, God, that's going to be amazing. And then we go to Mosul, Canada. Hallelujah. We go to Kashmir Valley up there on the rim with all the Pashtuns, the people that they say you can't go to because you're going to die. We're going and we're going to live, and the glory of God will be made manifest. And then we go to Africa. Now, I'm really excited about Africa because, you know, we're going to be there training the missionaries and the leaders there, and I love it. And they're just like that when they told Ann and I that they were just wanting us to, all the leaders were asking for us to come. They wanted us to come back. There was no way I could say no. So we're going to go back and do their leadership conference again this year. But, you know, that's a lot of flying. It's a lot of hours. You know, so we just need all of you to pray for Ann. Because she doesn't sleep much at night. And so we're just believing God. You pray with us. We believe in God to get us really inexpensive business class tickets. I mean, almost every time the Lord gives us, you know, just works a miracle for us so that we don't have to be, you know, back there in the super cramped section, you know, where if you move, you feel like you're basically invading someone else's privacy. Because it's tough. 36 hours like that's tough. Thank you, Jesus. Maybe we just got to have to turn this thing around and start recognizing, wait a minute. This is holy and sacred ground. Our ancestors came here long ago. I know there's been abusive men and men who've done many things wrong, but my ancestors came here in the early 1600s to make this a place of a revival ground. They consecrated this place so that the great outpourings of the Holy Ghost would be poured out upon all the nations of the earth as God brought them here to this place called sanctuary. Yeah. And now all of a sudden we're getting all arrogant and all high-minded. What, we're going to build something like a wall or whatever, you know, we're going to kick everybody out, you know, and then interview who's going to come in. They got to be as arrogant as we are, then they can come. I mean, come on, who wants to live in a world like that? Father wants to take and move by his Spirit and change the dynamics of what's going on in the United States of America. Father wants this once again to be the holy and sacred ground that our ancestors dedicated it to God for. I'm telling you, I was just with my dear friend who is the Grand Chief of the Cree Indian. It's the largest American Indian tribe in North America, the largest one. And he's the only Grand Chief who sits on the board, who sits on the UN. He's a Grand Chief, the son of a Grand Chief, the son of a Grand Chief, the son of a Grand Chief, and he's full of the Holy Ghost. And what they're saying is, Holy Ghost, come take over the land. Hallelujah. He's a great host. Hallelujah. And there have been many different men like him over the years, and the church is going to have to rise up from the place that it's in, but it's not going to happen without you. You have to do your part. You have to understand that your part is to get baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire and learn how to live in Christ Jesus and walk in him. When you say, Lord, I want a greater anointing, you're saying, I want the Holy Ghost to flow through me with a greater dimension of his person. That's what you're saying. You're saying, and so when we're praying, oh Lord Jesus, I want you to be revealed, your life and your power to be revealed in a greater way, then we've got to understand the difference between right and wrong. We got to understand the difference between walking in the Holy Ghost and walking in demon spirits, between the compromises of the things that the world would try to impose upon us and a consecrated, sanctified life. People haven't, I mean, it's like it's hard pressed to hear anybody preach on sanctification unless you're around me. I mean, sanctification is the life that we live. It's the life that we live in Christ Jesus. Yes. It's just too bad that people don't understand this wonderful life of being able to come out from among them, and touch not the unclean thing, saith God, and I shall receive you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I'll be your God, and you'll be my sons and my daughters. And that's not for the Amish or the Anabaptist, the Brethren and the Mennonite. You know, that's where the Anabaptists come from. You know that. They're all from one place with different expressions. There was a time where the Anabaptists had something going on. They lost it, but man, you know what? Everybody's in opportunity to come back. And that's what happens over and again. You know, there is a generation who begins to seek God, and they take a hold of God. They pray and press into the realm of the glory. And then the second generation just seems to be left out. Or by the third generation, it seems like it dies down. Somehow they didn't pass the torch. They got caught away in the glory and forgot about all the stuff that was going on around them. They should have had one eye open looking to see where everybody's at. Huh? I was just in a church, and I got in a church. The church was full of the glory of God. I was precious. I was so blessed by it. And the anointing was just, you know, and the coming of the Holy Ghost was just wonderful. And then, and all of the adults were up front, and they were all just captivated, man. They were like sponges ready for any drop of water out of heaven. I mean, there was going to be no water, no manifestation of the power of God wasted. And all of their children were over in the back corner, stood in the back corner, all talking with each other, doing this, and look, you know, totally distracted. I'm telling you, you know what I did. I rearranged the entire program. Hallelujah. Praise God. And because we're going to have to understand, we can't have a bleed going out the back door because we're caught up in the glory while our children are messing around. They never even made a connection with the realms of the glory. They've never made a connection with the anointing. They've been put in the nursery too many times, shoved in the corner too many times, you know, slapped and said, be quiet too many times. Come on, get them up here dancing. I don't care if somebody's even acting like they're doing the whatever, you know. Well, you need to put some other models in front of her, man. She was like, that's okay, man. That's okay. It was beautiful. It was beautiful because it was in the context of participating with what's going on in the house of God, and the Holy Ghost can move in on that big time. It's when you sit, when you're offline, we're just sitting there all overwhelmed with the circumstances and the cares and the issues and the discouragement and the fear and the things that Satan would heap on you. And I'm going to talk to you a bit about that here. I want you to understand that when you look at the reality that right now, angels of darkness, so we call them fallen angels, but the Bible calls them the devil and his angels. So they're the devil's angels, which is more appropriate and specific, but we understand them as fallen angels. Angels of darkness is another way that we describe it. They're not dead. They didn't go away. They're not living vacationing on Pluto. They have not been moved out into the outer limits of the universe, and they're out there somewhere running around doing something, you know, causing each other problems. They're right here. They're right here. And somehow I don't think people realize that what they're up against, that they're in a battle, that there is a warring power of darkness. See, all that is in the world, Satan has his craft and his tools that he uses to either neutralize you or to assimilate you, which is was far worse. To neutralize you to where that you don't have the boldness and the confidence to flow and operate in the Holy Ghost. You don't have that hookup in that relationship to where that you just naturally, you sneeze and devils go out. Not out of you, out of somebody who heard you sneeze. Are you listening to me? Hey, you just look at somebody and they get delivered. Praise God. Hallelujah. You walk into a place and people start feeling the glory of heaven. I mean, just because you live in that. But Satan is opposed to the anointing. He is opposed to every expression of the anointing. He personifies antichristism. Do you understand? It is everything anti of God. It's anti of the anointing. It's anti of the manifest presence of God. His whole oppressive power is to shut down any influence of the manifest presence of God in our lives. And he's a master of his craft. And you've got to understand how to deal with him. First of all, you need to be aware that you're not ignorant of his devices, but you can plainly see. And when you do, all of a sudden, he's not able to trick you into participating with his death, and you think it's a good time. Death is never a good time. Death is always going to bring something that is destructive. It's corruption. You don't sow to the flesh and reap eternal life. You sow to the flesh, you'll reap corruption. You sow to the Holy Ghost, you sow to the things of the Spirit, and you're going to reap the things of the life of God. You're going to mature and grow and bring forth fruit unto perfection. And this is what we need, both in the areas of the fruits of the Spirit, the nature and demeanor of God, which is splendor and majesty and glory and everything that is good. You need lowliness and meekness, because otherwise you're never going to understand how to cooperate with the Holy Ghost. And God trains you in lowliness and meekness the way you interact with me. The way you interact with your parents. The way that you interact other authorities in your life. Oh, yeah. Even the way that you interact with one another, because you're supposed to understand how to esteem everybody better than yourself and serve one another in love. You're supposed to understand how to be clothed with humility and walk in love, because there you are actually learning how to hook up with the Holy Spirit and move with Him. How to let Him flow through you uninterrupted and unhindered. Oh, yeah. There is a great reward in obeying God. There's something good going on in every act of obedience. And everything He tells us to do, when we do it, it causes us to be able to function in the things that He has freely given to us. I want you to grab a hold of it tonight in the name of Jesus. Every mind-blinding spirit, and I'm telling you, mind-blinding spirits will work in full, but they also work in part. Blind spots. As it were, things you just can't get, things that you just can't understand, things that you just don't see how it's meaningful or relevant. You just never get it, never becomes a living reality. It never becomes something that you need so desperate. Huh. Tonight, if you were out on the streets and you had no place to go, it was beginning to rain, you had no food, you had no shelter, you'd be desperate. Yeah. You'd be desperate.
Yeah.
Oh, you'd be looking for an answer and a supply. I'm going to tell you right now, dear people, the Lord even kind of makes it a little bit more of a radical situation. He said, if you're like a person in the desert where there is no water. Now, people can't relate to that as much of being in a big city. But in a desert, in a hot desert, in a place where there is no water, and your tongue faileth you for thirst. That means it's swollen because your kidneys are starting to shut down. Your tongue faileth you. In other words, your tongue won't work anymore. It's swollen in your mouth. It means your kidneys are shutting down, and it means that your legs are starting to swell up, fill up with water now. You're about to die. He said, then you call out for me. You call out in that desperation. You call out in that urgency. That's because urgency is another word for supplication. So with all prayer and supplication in the Holy Ghost, that's all prayer and urgency. It's a pleading prayer. You know, you call out with that kind of urgency, and Father said, so that kind of neediness, that kind of hunger, that kind of sincerity, that kind of desperation. And it's not that Father wants desperation, He wants truth. He wants us to really want this. That's why he says, I'm going to, he likens how we're supposed to come and ask Him to a person who's at his neighbor's house, banging on his door saying, get up! Hey, get up in there and get me something. And He says, that's what I want you to do. Hallelujah. He said He will not rise because He is a friend, but He will rise because He's going to keep on banging and screaming. And Father says, that's the way I want you to talk to me. Why? Because He wants to see something that is real on the inside of us. We can't live without it. We've got to have it. We're not going to stop banging. We're staying right here. This is why men ought to pray and not to faint. Because we understand where Father's heart is at and how sacred these things are, and that He's going to give them to us even though we can't deserve them or ever earn them. And He wants to know that we're going to take that which is sacred and not profane it. And we want it more than anything else. We won't profane it, more than likely. And when we want it more than anything else, when we can't live without it. And people, I believe that when God's people begin to take, grab a hold of an understanding that it is an absolute essential, it's absolutely essential that you learn how to be an overcomer. You must understand how to overcome this world. You must understand how to overcome Satan at every point. You must learn. Jesus puts it in the context of what He Himself did. If you overcome as I overcame, then you will sit down with me in my throne, even as I sat down with my Father on His throne. This is the victory. This is the overcoming power that overcomes the world, even this realm of faith. Hallelujah. This realm of living in Him, of oneness with Him. People want to compromise right, left, and center. They don't want to recognize that they are at war with all that is in the world. All that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life, the lust of the flesh, everything that Satan can try to elicit through the physical realm of your body to do things that will actually defile. Listen, I'm telling you, what's going on. You know, the Lord has allowed sin to go on in part because He, and I know this because He showed it to me in His Word. that the little bit of, just a little bit of sin, just a little small little bit of disobedience that took place in the garden will ultimately lead to a place where men want to destroy God and do away with him altogether. That's where all sin leads. You know, and what's going on right now is, you know, people say, well, you know, we got to sin more or less every day. Well, Satan's setting you up to participate in the most wicked and vile sin that is ever going to be made manifest, and it's the worship of Satan and the beast. That's where men are going. That's where men are going. And it's such a vile, lewd, immoral desecration of who a human being is that they can never be forgiven. That's how vile it is. That's how vile it is. God focuses his eternal destruction on those people. And they're in a category all of their own. But when you are dealing with all these other things in the lust of the flesh, those things that Satan would try to do through the things that he could elicit within the framework of your physical body, the lust of the eye, everything that you could look after and covet and want to have for yourself, the shiny objects, the big house, the nice car, the all this and the all that. And then even worse than that, the pride of life, which is the stubbornness and the rebellion and the greed and the arrogance, and I've got to have it my way, the self-exaltation. It's a war against you. All that is in the world. It's not of the Father. But you're not of the world. The world is contrary to you. To have any allegiance or friendship with the world is an act of treason against the Father. It's an act of treason. It literally is an act of war. It's an act. It is literally creating or making war against the kingdom of God. Is that radical or what? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? It's about time that you come on over fully, 100% with total abandonment. It's about time. It's about time that you make up your mind whose side you're on. Because Father is looking for people that begin to participate in the glorious church. Once again, the church is the fullness of him that filleth all things. But if you're not willing to participate with it in your life, the way that you're going to live out your Monday, the way that you're going to live out your Tuesday, the way you're going to live out the rest of the week, you're never going to understand how to participate with the Holy Ghost in that which Father has made the church to be, because you're going to be under oppressive power of darkness. You will live under an oppressive power of the satanic. There are various different levels of this satanic realm. And we would start talking about it just in general, temptation. But you know how you can effectively deal with temptation, huh? Because every person in here, I'm certain there was a time in your life that you had some kind of sin going on in your life. You knew you were not right with God because of it. You reached into the power of God. And you stood against it, and now it has no power over your life. Isn't that true, everybody in this place? Well, all sin's that way. All sin's that way. It only comes at you hard for a season. And you take a stand against it, and God moves in and tells the devil, you leave him alone now. He's done proving to you over and again, that he wants nothing to do with any of your iniquity. You know, one of the things I'm talking to Father all about, I tell Father this all the time. Father, I say it with urgency. Father, I want your help. I want your protection. Satan, I want nothing to do with Satan. I want nothing to do with demon spirits. I want nothing to do with their iniquity. Oh, God, come protect me. Oh, God, come keep me. Oh, God, come rescue me. Oh, God, come strengthen me. Oh, God, come help me. Oh, Lord, for only you can overthrow this one, this enemy of my soul. Can you hear me? Because I'm telling you, I know right now, there's not very many people like me in the earth. And that's the sad reality. That's the sad reality. People compromising right, left, and center. And then somebody comes with this zeal of the Lord that has consumed them. And they don't know what's going on. Because they're used to listening to people just pacify them and, you know, tell them how good they are and how better they're going to be. Nonsense. I mean, we are nothing without him and can do nothing without him. Without him, we can do nothing, but through him, we can do all things. And it's learning a dependency. It's learning a dependency. You've got to get in the crisis moment to recognize how desperate you're in need of him. People think that they can just skate on in cheating on God. You're not skating in nowhere but hell. You're not going to cheat on God. You've got a lifetime to learn how to say no to sin. And if you don't learn it, you're going to spend an eternity without God. You listen to me. You better get urgent. You better get the fear of God. You understand that the Spirit of the Lord and the manifestation of the full anointing of the Holy Ghost is the Spirit of the Lord. It is the Spirit of wisdom, the Spirit of understanding. It's the Spirit of might and Spirit of counsel, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. People need to get the fear of the Lord. An awe of who he is. To stand in awe of him and what? Be in awe in him and? Be awe in him. Be in awe of him and? Yeah. Ya'ar in Hebrew language is to be in awe. To be overwhelmed with his power, his glory, his majesty. Are you listening to me? Some of us have been in some difficult situations. I remember one time when I was a little grommet, and all of a sudden this wall of water is coming at me, and I'm going, at that moment it seemed like it was as tall as that ceiling right there. And I go, I'm out there in the water surfing, and I'm thinking, I am not having fun right now. I am getting ready to die. But his majesty, his glory, his splendor is far more overwhelming than that. And yet he looks at you and I with a great big smile on his face, with his arms open wide, saying, come on in. And he gives us boldness to be able to stand there because of a love relationship. Huh? And he that dwells in love dwells in God. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness, even in the day of judgment when his eyes are like a flame of fire. Huh? You know what? When I'm marching around here and you can see, I'm in the zone, man. And my veins are popping out. Huh? And there's a few people that are smiling because they're captivated with the anointing. Everybody else is. But just imagine standing in the presence of Father when he's bringing the judgment down. But you in this relationship with him, you in the same realm, you in the same love connection, my goodness. And you're just standing there going, woo! True. I want you to see heaven. I want you to begin to enjoy the glory of it. I want you to begin to enjoy the beauty of it. He'll bring you all the way in. He draws you with cords of loving kindness and tender mercies. You're a cowboy, that's like team roping. My goodness, Holy Ghost around the neck, you know, Lord Jesus, the back of heels and pulls you in. Hallelujah. Ha, you strung out there. Praise God. God is so good to us. And, you know, he doesn't let up. He doesn't let up. He doesn't let up. Even in the midst of our, sin, even in the midst of our offense, he still allows his presence to come upon us. He still draws us. He still pours out his love. That's not God giving him approval of your life. That's telling you he still loves you. There's still mercy. There's still grace. You can still walk in this way. He's still saying, come on in. Choose me. Come walk with me. Come live with me. I'm better than the devil any day. My righteousness is better than sin. My holiness better than iniquity every day of eternity. God wants to teach you the ways of life. You're going to have to stop doing your own pleasure. Call the holy things of God a delight to his pleasure. Then you shall find the delight of the Lord. And then you'll walk upon your high places and he'll feed you with the heritage of Jacob. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. People, you got to recognize what you're up against. And that's why Paul says, be strong in the strength of the Lord and the power of his might. And take unto yourself all of God's divine ability. And it's likened as a whole armor. Take unto yourself the armor of God. God's armor is talked about by the prophets. He's girded himself with truth and put upon his helmet of salvation. Huh? That's his armor. That's his glory. That's his anointing. That is his presence. That's his knowledge. That's his wisdom. That's his insight. That's his righteousness. That's his holiness. That's his life. That's his life. That's the life of Jesus. About 6 months ago, it was longer than that now, the Lord spoke to me and said, I'm going to open up doors for you all over America. You're going to go tell people to receive the life of Christ. About 3 months ago, 4 months ago, it started happening. All over America, we're preaching all over the United States of America this year. We're running so hard, we don't even know how we're going to be able to do it. We were saying we're going to just start off just doing one a month, and now it's already in some places 3 a month already. And we're just trying to figure out how we're going to manage all these different things. The Lord's going to give it away, make a way. But I'm going to tell you right now, Father is urgent concerning his purpose and his promises. He's watching over his word to hasten it. He says to me, son of man, what do you see? I said, I see a church without your life. He says, prophesy. Tell them, I'm watching over my word to bring it to pass. I'm watching over my word to hasten it. I know I took that in the context of Son of Man, what do you see? I see a pot of return towards the north concerning Babylon coming down to take Israel, the southern kingdom, into captivity. And he says, yes, and I watch over my word to hasten it, to bring it to pass. Those are the words of the Father, his promises, the things that he's purposed to do. What's on his time calendar? What's on his schedule right now? What is on his schedule is a great awakening to the nation. But what has to happen before a great awakening to the nation? What always has to happen? His church has got to be revived. We have to turn back. We have to allow God to restore unto us the joy of our salvation. Then sinners shall be taught in the way, and transgressors shall be converted. Hallelujah. I was in a meeting not too long ago down in Arlington, Texas, and the power of God just swept into the place while I was towards the end of the meeting. Just a wonderful thing, and an anointing came upon me. I started singing, "When the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were as them that dreamed. Then was our mouth filled with laughter and our tongues with singing. Then said they among the heathen, the Lord has done great things for them." When God shows up, because in the sense that he's seen upon our lives, and this is what Father wants, he's not made it very difficult. How hard is it to step into all the majesty and the glory of the heaven? Just stand up. That's all you got to do. He says, "Arise and shine, for your glory has come." Hallelujah. The glory of the Lord is risen upon you like the rising of the noonday sun. It's just that you and I've got to come all the way over. It can't just be a moment, an hour, a day, a couple of days. We've got to be willing to stand the test of every adversity that Satan would throw at us. And it come to be found that he comes against us but has nothing in us. And the authority of God is released through us. And Satan cannot stand him. It's a battle. It's a war. It is a battle. It is a struggle. You wrestle not against flesh or blood. It's up close, hand-to-hand combat, grappling. Yeah. And people not entered into it. They've not entered into the grapple. They've not got into the press of the thing. And it's not some kind of a tormentuous hard thing. Because, I mean, goodness, when you got the Spirit of the Lord upon you like Samson, I mean, you're taking them right, left, and center. You're having fun throwing them across the universe kind of thing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love authority over demon spirits, but my authority over demon spirits that was given to me in Christ Jesus was solidified and began to be manifested because Satan would come at me and try to tempt me with the same stuff he tempts you. And I said, in Jesus' name, no. God's come strengthen me, help me. I want nothing to do with your lies, you foul spirit of hell. I was able to see an angel of darkness and the demon spirits that he releases rather than just looking at a possibility, an option, an opportunity to do something that's going to be create some kind of pleasure. There's no pleasure at all. It's destruction and abuse. Satan so sets himself against man to destroy any similitude or image of God in them. Listen to me. In less than 1,565 years, Satan, the demons of hell, the angels of darkness, were able to so impose upon men their wickedness and teach men their wickedness that there was altogether no likeness of God left in man. And he says, "It grieves me in my heart. I repent that I ever made them. I will destroy all flesh from off the face of the earth." That's Father God. That's our loving Father. That's what I say. That's what sin is about. Sin is all about the means by which Satan does everything he possibly can to destroy any similitude and any image of God's glory and of his beauty and of his splendor within our lives. It's about time you get fighting mad. Hallelujah. It's about time you get filled with the zeal of the Lord and the glory of his life, that you fall in love with his presence, that you understand that truly there is in his right hand is joy unspeakable and full of glory. In his presence, there's at his right hand is pleasures forevermore. In his presence, there's joy unspeakable and full of glory. At his right hand, there's pleasures forevermore. People have been scraping the bottom of the garbage, the filthy garbage can. They've been drinking out of the septic system and saying this all the pleasure and all the delight they know. Oh, what happens when you come and sit up at the table of the Father? Hallelujah. Start drinking from the pure streams. Hallelujah. That flow from the throne of God. One day right now, you're not gonna even be able to handle the smell of what you used to be drinking. Huh? You won't even be able to get near it. It's like, whoa, I used to drink that. Whoa. Oh, yeah. When you begin to live in spiritual purity, you believe me. The contrast has ever been that traumatic, that drastic. It truly is. It smells like death. I want to just grab a hold of this. Understand this. You wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness in high places. See, Jesus spoiled principalities and powers. There's no question about it. The whole of the spiritual realm was changed from what it was in Daniel's day. Remember, Daniel begins to pray and he goes to prayer. Now, this is supplication, intercession prayer. It wasn't his daily prayer. His daily prayer that he prayed three times a day, where he knelt down and stretched his hand before God. He would just begin to pray and give thanks unto the Lord. It was just thanksgiving, enjoying the presence of the Lord kind of prayer. Well, he said himself, after recognizing that they were supposed to have things and realized that they didn't have them, and boy, would that ever be a breakthrough for the church. Suddenly say, wait a minute, I'm supposed to have a river and I even have a sprinkle. Are you listening to me? I'm supposed to have greater works and I don't even have these works. You know what I'm saying? Then all of a sudden you start seeking God and say, well, listen, what's going on around here? Why is it that we're in our situation that we're in? Father will show you. Just as he did Daniel. Daniel goes to pray, sets himself to praying about 3 weeks, about 21 days. And the angel of the Lord finally comes to him at the end of that period of time. Said, Daniel, you're highly beloved and favored of the Lord. From the first moment that you began to pray, God heard you. But there were hindering spirits that held back that which God wanted to bring to you. There was angels of darkness. The prince of Persia stood up against me. The angel that ruled over Persia. Huh? Listen to me. Tokuna Masheka. Stood up against me. And I had no one to help. And then Gabriel came and stood alongside of me. And we're able to come break through to bring to you the understanding of the things that are going to happen in your time and in the time of the up until the time of the end. So he got the so total unfolding of all the major events that are going to happen to the people of Israel in the time that the Lord Jesus comes sets up his kingdom. Well, people, it's changed now. Praise God. The Lord has made a complete separation between the two. And now, having spoiled principalities and powers of darkness, spiritual wickedness, and made an open shame of them, showing that they are completely defeated, triumphed over them in it. Having said at the cross, now is the prince of this world cast out, and if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. In other words, Satan has no power and ability to hold men in captivity and blind their eyes anymore from the reality of the truth. He tells us that the grace of God has appeared to all men. I mean, he's to teach us now to deny worldliness and ungodliness and live righteous and godly in this present world. So now the door is open for all men to be able to come in. And we see is what Paul said in Colossians chapter 1 and 13, that he's delivered us from
the powers of darkness.
He's delivered us from
powers of darkness.
He delivered us from the powers, right, of darkness. Is the powers of darkness still at work? Huh? Is the God of the atmosphere, the God of this world, the prince of the power of the air, the prince of the power of the air that comes to Jesus and said, it's all mine. Bow down and worship me and I'll give it to you. I'm going to tell you right now, he's wanting men to bow down and worship him from the very beginning that he was lifted up in his heart and he drew the angels away who stood before the mighty presence of God throughout the eternities of time. What can he do to you and me? Who is any match for him? The Lord delivered us from the powers of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of dear Son so that they are uniquely and separately divided. There is no integration of it. There's no integration of it. It is completely and totally separated. It happened at the cross. See, it was totally separated until Adam opened up the door. And when he opened up the door, through disobedience, sin came into the world and death by sin. And so now sin and death reigned over all men, even those who did not sin after the similitude of Adam. That was there. The state of men was under the pseudo-sovereignty of the reign of darkness, of the reign of Satan. It was as though things were integrated. And God was able to take one family and isolate them and sanctify them and set them apart and give them a gift of holiness and righteousness that he may dwell in the midst of them. And it was a family named Abraham. Abraham's family, and he set himself apart that he might have a people who would worship him, who would know him, who he could dwell in the midst of them, so that he might bring forth the Savior, the seed of the woman, to crush the head of the serpent. You hear me? You hear me? This thing has been done now. But it's still a battle. Satan is as much a rebel against God as Pharaoh ever was. All Pharaoh was is a son of Satan. That's all he was. Huh? They call him the son of God, but he was a son of God, the God of this world, you see. And he was just emulating his father, the devil. He was one of the first types. Well, Nimrod was the first type of Antichrist, but Pharaoh, the whole line of Pharaohs were primarily, especially the wicked Pharaohs of the days of Moses, were perfect images, really, of the Antichrist, their whole religious system, and on down to the various different kingdoms. But I'm not going to talk about that. But I want you to understand, we can look around us and we can see Satan's behavior and mannerisms manifested all around us in people, and the greed and the hate and the strife and the envy, huh? Where there's, what? Where there's envy, huh? There, what?
It's every evil one.
That's right, envy and strife, envy and divisions and strife, those kinds of things. Can you imagine that is fully giving yourself over to be shaped and take on the likeness of a demonic realm, to take on the likeness of the satanic realm, to give full place to the very spirit of the devil? I mean, they're not fortified. They're not fortified. They're not fortified. They don't understand how to live over here in the realms of the Holy Ghost, how to live over here in the light of His Word, to recognize what Satan's doing and say, wait a minute, I want none of that darkness. So the reality of it is, as though those realms are separated, you and I can live in a place right now where Satan can't access us. It's just, I mean, Job had a hedge and Satan couldn't touch him. Here's what he told God. He said, well, you got a hedge around him, I can't touch him. Satan believes that if God allows him, he says this. Basically, this is his attitude, okay? You let me touch them. You let me get at them in any way, and I'll cause them to curse you. They'll bow down and worship me. They'll grapple at my feet like a dog and lick my toes. No, that's a tyrant. That's a tyrant. That's the tyrants of the past that the Antichrist is going to fully manifest beyond all. He's going to be the summation of all tyrants of the past. There's a kingdom's getting ready to rise up that is the tyrant kingdom is getting ready to rise up. I'm doing a book. I'm so excited about it that Charisma is so excited about publishing it because it's such a timely book. Getting ready to send over to the editors, you know, in the next week or two. And it really describes where we're at right now, what's going to happen between now and the time that the Antichrist is going to be revealed on the earth. A world war is going to come because there's going to be about 43 sovereign nations that are going to be turned in to 10 tyrannical kingdoms. And out of those 10 tyrannical kingdoms, the Antichrist will rise up out of them. They will exist before the catching away of the church. They will exist. We will be hated of all nations for His namesake. It's going to, and for people who don't know, it's going to look like we're in the full-blown tribulation and ain't even started yet. It's going to get far worse. Huh? Because the full-blown tribulation will be demarcated by the first outpouring of God's wrath as is seen in the first of the seals. Huh? And then it gets over. Before you're done with the first 3.5 years of tribulation, you have almost 50% of the population of the earth has been destroyed. 50% of humanity. No mountains, no islands. You know you're in some serious situation. I'm not going to be around. I'm going to be at the marriage supper of the Lamb. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hasakita bada. Hallelujah. I'm going to be caught up with the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm going to beat the 144,000 there. Hallelujah. I'll be waiting on them. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'll already be in a full-blown dance by the time they show up. Oh, look, I saw you. Dancing around the throne. You know, we're really gone to a very good place. I mean, you know, I like to tell people due to 30-year plans. People look at me like, 30-year plan? I don't even know what I'm going to do tomorrow. But I like people to do their 30-year plans in the context of their 10,000-year plan. What's your 10,000-year plan look like? Because you can lay that out. And if you get your 10,000-year plan all squared away, hallelujah, what I'm going to be doing 10,000 years from now, we headed to a good place. We on the road, I see we're headed to a very good place. We're headed to an eternity with Him ruling and reigning with Him in the New Jerusalem, hallelujah, and to a place where God will create an eternal perfect earth, where He'll make a new heaven and a new earth wherein dwells only righteousness. Oh, we on our way to a good place. And there is a lot of things trying to stop us. The armies of ill are coming out against us, trying to recruit us, trying to neutralize us, trying to assimilate us, trying to gain that much more strength and that much more power to stop anything that God would possibly do amongst humanity. Over and again, Father only had one man. Not one man's all He needed. He had Enoch. He had Noah. The rest of the family got in on it because of Noah. Hallelujah. Hey, listen to me. He had Job. He had one man. He had Jesus. He had one man. Hallelujah. God don't need no more champions. He's got Jesus. And now we stand in Him and He stands in us. He invites us to come live in Him. Our whole life we get to live in Him. What a privilege. You know, I mean, I can understand where He says, come and dwell in me. That's great. I mean, because like, it's come be with me. I'll protect you and I'll take care of you. That, you know, that's pretty, that's awesome. And it's beautiful and I'm doing it. And I've got to tell you right now, I've got a leg wrapped around Him. I'm just like, hey, come on. You know what I'm saying? I'm not letting go of you. Huh? Hallelujah. Like a drowning man trying to get ahead, keep the head above water. Praise God. But then He says, and I will dwell in you. That blows me away right there. I can understand the invitation to come dwell in Him. But He says, and I'll come dwell in you. Whoa. Whoa. What have you done for me? This unspeakable gift of salvation. This great grace where you have made me a place that you delight to dwell. Come on, people. You don't want to miss out on this by all that stupid compromise. Come on now. You all mess out on this by listening to the lies and being constantly tripped up. God has given us authority. The Holy Ghost is bigger than Satan, the spirit of darkness, any day. God has given authority to the smallest one among us to cast out devils, to tell unclean spirits that they must lose their hold. Think about it, dear people. Think about it. Think about who's living on the inside of you. Think about the greater one that is on the inside of you. That is a testimony that cannot be compromised. I hear people walking around pointing the finger about all these various different false doctrines and what they think is a cult and what they think is heresy. I'm going to tell you right now, God says, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit. You look at the one who's got the greater one living on the inside of them, and that's the one who's got the real reality of the salvation saving grace. I mean, I jumped ahead, but that's exactly what it's saying. People lost in the semantics. They're lost in the loop, spinning around in their confusion. And they never understood the true test of the believer is the power to overcome the wicked one. I write unto you young men because the word of God abides in you and you have defeated the wicked one. You've overcome the wicked one. You defeated Satan at every point. Huh? There's the proof. Every spirit that does not confess that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is not of God. But you are of God, little ones, and you overcome them because greater is He that is in you. Hallelujah. The true testimony is there. Huh? Because in the Hebrew language and in the Greek language, when we talk about the Lord coming into the earth, we're talking about the earthly vessel that He made from the earth, the clay. Hallelujah. The fine dust. Ha ha. Mondasa teke oposhaha. Mande histekeli piatarana. Satan is able to do more things right now through the compromises that the church has allowed demon spirits to access them. Every movie is made with a formula to draw you into an iniquity called lasciviousness. And people have gotten addicted to looking at leg, to looking at immorality, to looking at that which Satan uses to bring you into a stronghold of immorality, to the ultimate place of the defilement of men in homosexuality. That is the ultimate defilement of men. Sexual immorality is a defilement of men. God says this, he that commits fornication and defiles the temple, I will destroy that person in hell. That's God's wrath. That's the Lord saying, I'm in this game now. That's where He says, I am the Lord. You hear Him in Leviticus. He said, don't you do that. I am the Lord your God. Huh? Because He's saying, I'm going to cut you off. Karit, I will cut you off. And now Satan knows it, and so he's created a system and a place to be able to operate where people have made normalized and called it common. I'm going to tell you right now, Mariah Woodworth Edder would have been raking you over the coals right now. She'd been picking you up by the nape of the neck and kicking you out the church. Oh, yeah. Go read about it. These are holiness people. These are holiness people. They didn't believe looking like, acting like the world. And that's why you saw great signs and wonders and miracles. That's why there were great exploits of the power of God. Go read their doctrines. Go read what they preached. to participate watching things on television, and my goodness, what they would have seen at this time in their day to us would look so innocent and harmless. I mean, you know, Satan has so wound up the clock of adrenaline, you got to see guts flying, blood flying, people being blown up, thrown out of cars, jumping out of airplanes, just, you know, chopping, dicing, whatever. And now that's exciting. You watch a Charlie Chaplin silent film, you're like, this is boring, man. What is he doing now? And now people like Mariah Woodworth or Smith Wigglesworth, they'd say, that is profane. You are now drinking right out of the demonic realm of hell. That's what they would say. That's what they would say. You know, one day, there was a preacher who was still alive just back in the 90s who was with Wigglesworth. And one day he showed up at Wigglesworth's front porch, and he had a newspaper underneath his arm. And Wigglesworth came to the door, and Wigglesworth looked at him and said, what's that underneath your arm? He immediately took it and threw it under the bush. Because there ain't no newspaper coming in my house. What? That is weird, man. That is weird. You're a legalist. Well, look at the greater one that lived on the inside, and look at the power of God. Look at this. Everybody wants to talk about having the power and the glory and the anointing displayed in their life like these men of old, but they don't want their doctrine. Now, guess what? You're not going to have their anointing without their consecration. You're not, I'm going to tell you right now, consecration, separation unto God, where Satan can't access you, has a direct relationship to the display of the life of Jesus Christ and the flow of the Holy Ghost through you. You listen to me. Father still shows his mercy. I'm going to say it again. Father still shows his loving kindness. People living compromised life, living in disobedience, living on the roller coaster. It's time you get off the roller coaster, get in the rocket, and take straight up. Amen. Take off. No more roller coaster. Boom. Right. By God, John. We're strapped in. We're coming, Father. Hallelujah. Not up and down and up and down and back and around and up and down. The church, we cannot be willing to accommodate something less than what Father demands, the church to be the fullness of him that filleth all things. Jesus was set up above all principalities and powers and might and dominion, and we're seated with him in a place where Satan cannot touch us. Amen. He's given us authority to tread upon scorpions and serpents and over all the power of the enemy, and we're letting Satan run right over top of us. We walk all over the sacred things of God, wonder why the anointing isn't manifested. Uh-oh. And there's nothing more sacred than your temple, than your life, your thinking realm. Your emotions, affections, attitudes, and appetites. Oh, Sana Maya Tahala Makaya. Father, why don't you come over here and jump in the Holy Ghost and love it all day long. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Vada Koste Perinasha. All the guys, whether it was Booth or whether it was Mooney or whether it was Wigglesworth or John G. Lake or F.F. Bosworth, they said they saw a church coming where nobody lived in the glory of God. They live in an apostate, compromised realm with demonic spirits saying that they're the children of the Most High. Huh? And they weren't too, they were right on, because that's what the scripture says anyways. It's the apostate church giving place to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. It's time for us to get back over in the holy realm. It's time for us to get back over living in the holies of holies. I mean, not Takaya. Recognizing that your life is the holies of holies. Hallelujah. Recognizing that a big part of the battle that you're having to come up against is keeping yourself praising and giving thanks all day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just people walk around saying, Father, I'm just so blessed with all the things that you're doing in my life. You are an amazing God. Delighting yourself in the Lord, doing his own pleasure. Not doing your own pleasure, but doing his pleasure. Calling the rest of the Lord sacred and the people of God honorable and the holy of God honorable. You know what I'm saying? Isaiah chapter 58, verse 11 through 13. Because the Sabbath, we live every day in Sabbath. Now the Sabbath is about the rest. We've come into the rest. Jesus is the Sabbath. He's the fulfillment. It's completion of all the work of God. Father finished his work. Amen in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody say, well, I like to go to church on Saturday. This is how I like to go to church on Sunday. You know, they're pointing the finger at who's right and who's wrong. You need to go to church every day, especially you guys that are pointing the finger at each other. Amen. Arguing about entering into strife and division. Are you listening to me? It's about time we start living out this life. We got to understand what we are up against. The demon spirits that we're up against. God said, submit yourself unto him and resist the devil and he will flee. Satan goes about as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. Think about this, people. When are you going to wake up? So I stop and stop sitting there going, you know, cute little kitty cat. The total blind person got their hand out. Nice kitty. No, it's the roaring lion, man. You're about to lose your hand. Nice kitty. Blind, deaf, you know? Jesus, help us. The enemy of your soul come out to destroy you, come out to steal your inheritance. Oh, sapara de shikinama. I'm just so worn out. I'm just so tired. I'm just so worn out. What is my inheritance, my birthright, the value to me when I'm so hungry? I'll trade it for a bowl of beans. It happens. It happens. I watch people do that. Don't do that. Come on now. Come on. There's a place of enjoying his presence, to continually be refreshed by him. There's a place of coming into intimacy and relationship with him to where that everything that you hear and read about in the Bible, you begin to experience it. Yeah. And I'm going to tell you right now, as you do, you're in the rocket.
Yeah. Amen.
Because right now, when you start off, it's like, you know, I don't really see it. I don't really understand it. I'm just going to obey and I'm going to do what God says to do, even though I don't understand it and I don't really see it. I don't really feel like I'm really getting the reward and the consequences of it. I'm just going to be faithful to do what God says to do. I'm going to tell you right now, you do that. And if you're going to reap if you do not faint. Father will give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation that you can see the power of darkness. The enemy of your soul, the one who's set on destroying you and mocking God through your life, standing there in the place of anything that tempts you. So that you don't give place to it, because once you give place to it, it immediately becomes oppressive. Let me tell you about other things that become oppressive to you. Anything that is oppression ultimately brings you into a place where Satan can run interference to the flow of God to your life and through your life. Listen, it becomes mixed again, as it were. You compromised. Where you're offended, you receive offense. I've told people many times, I said, by the Spirit of the Lord, don't do that. And they think I'm upset. I'm telling you, man, you're getting some inside information. You want a word of knowledge? Here you go. Just coming through me. Don't do that. It's going to wreck your life. Then they get all offended. They get a spirit of offense. Now they live in an oppression. Because now they've got something against someone. Unforgiveness. Someone hurt you. Some bad issue. Things go on in the traffic tomorrow. You know, why can't you learn instead of getting all upset? I can't believe you just cut me off. Why don't you just learn to wave and smile? I had to get over. We were leaving, going out of town. I didn't realize where I was, you know. And, oh, no, I got to get over for the 210. And so I'm getting over quick. And I got this guy, I mean, he just blowing his horn. I wasn't that close to him. You know, it was totally safe. But he's all upset. He's blowing his horn, banging on his window. And so I turned and I went. And he's like looking at me. Do I know him? It really turns everything around, people, when we quit coming under the influence of the stuff that we come up against. You get a bill, and all of a sudden the bill overwhelms you with fear, overwhelms you with discouragement. Once again, that becomes oppressive. Anything that belongs to the realm of fear, where you're, and belongs to the realm of doubt and unbelief, just all that stuff, disappointment, discouragement, being overwhelmed, people, that's oppressive things. You can easily be drawn into something that causes you to live distant from the one who has promised to provide for you, protect you, and perfect you. You got to learn how to keep yourself. Keep your heart with all diligence. You're going to have to learn how to walk this out in a relationship with the Lord. That's why there's only one way for you to be fit for the battle, and that is to be continually filled. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So that's what I'm Mosejagiasha. So that's what I'm here to teach you tonight, Dilla Bozagaya. How to get filled. Mazandali Mandarete. And if you can't get filled in the context of this place, hallelujah. There's people right now, I don't care. It didn't matter what day they come in, what night they come in, it doesn't matter. I can tell them to stand up, I'll lay hands on them, immediately go out in the glory of heaven. There's other people who come stand here, and I don't matter if I stand here and pray for them all night, they're going to stand here looking exactly like they did when I first started praying for them. Some people have learned how to receive from heaven. Other people are still trying to mitigate the circumstance. Huh. We want you to come over into a place where there is, it's not about any other thing than your interaction with God personally, your interaction with the Holy Spirit personally. You begin to ask the Lord for a greater anointing. Start saying, Lord Jesus, I want your life and your power to be manifested in me in a more complete and glorious dimension. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost, I want you to be able to flow through me. Hallelujah. You know, I could do that right there. Just take that one theme. I'll be lost in God for at least 30 minutes just on that one thing. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost, you so wonderful. You right here with me. You come to teach me. You come to lead me. I don't want to get in your way anymore with all my stuff, my silly, stupid little stuff, my little concerns and worries. Holy Ghost, I want you to come take over every part of my being. Cause me to think like you, act like you, talk. Why, you so good, God. Hallelujah. You come to me like a wellspring and like a river. And we're 30 minutes to be gone. You'll be all caught away in God, lose the English language, staggering around in your living room. Hallelujah. Sometimes you got to get near your bed because you're going to fall out under the Holy Ghost, and so you don't have any catch yourself. Hallelujah. Now, when I get a little caught away, I just go recline on my easy chair, you know, step back, go, see, God, God, on my side. People, this is the life. Turn the television off. There are people in here, you're addicted to it. You're addicted to it. And as soon as you think about losing your subscription with the television provider, you're going to lose your peace. And you're going to think it's the Holy Ghost saying, no, you need that. It's not. It's a spirit of addiction. And you confused it with peace. Oh, I know what I'm talking about because I know about how oppressive spirits work. Then it goes to another level because you don't, God has you. I mean, listen, God is, think about the river. Anointing of the Holy Spirit, as he's allowed to flow through us, he just washes all of that stuff away from us, all those things that would try to oppress our thinking, try to be, you know, attach itself to us or fix a disappointment. Someone treating you wrong. Someone who said something bad about you. Huh? Father wants to so douse you in love that you just, persecution was like, come on, man, I'm getting blessed over here. Huh? I'm persecuted for righteousness' sake. His grace rest upon me. In other words, you're so full of love that doesn't even matter. You're more full of compassion towards them because you see them in their lost state, their needy state. I mean, Father wants to give us this protection. He wants to show us how to be endued with His glory continually, where Satan cannot access or can't, where the authority of the powers of darkness becomes so frustrated trying to get at us. Did they come at night in their dreams? Huh? I was in a place the other night. I laid down in the bed. As soon as I laid down in the bed, fell asleep. An angel of darkness had his head over top of me. I just reached up and snocked him upside the head just like that. I went back to sleep. I'm not kidding you. Because the Father gives us authority. The trick can't get at me in the day. He's trying to come get me at night. Huh? I was laying in somebody else's bed. That devil lived there. Hallelujah. Kato, that's sanctified after I was in there. Amen. One of those, I didn't even say Jesus. I was, threw my arm up there. Hallelujah. Come on, people. You're looking at me like, it can't be true. It's true. It's true. I want you to delight yourself in the Lord. I want you to enjoy the presence of God. Otherwise, Satan's going to run right up top of you, man. You're never going to know the life of the overcomer. You'll never know what it means to be more than a conqueror. You'll never know what it means to have the life of Jesus Christ dominating you, Christ Jesus ruling you, the Holy Ghost governing you. You'll just have moments of refreshing, but you'll be constantly taken back into captivity, into prison. It's time that the church stands up glorious. Hallelujah. It's time you get a hold of yourself and rule your own spirit. Submit it to the Holy Ghost and let God, the Holy Ghost, take charge of everything. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I praise God for those of you who hear the call of God. You've turned the television off. Hallelujah. You quit listening to all the garbage on CNN. It's the same as Days of Our Life. It's just as fictional. Fox News is all just a bunch of lies and garbage and spin. Hallelujah. Huh? It's like Wigglesworth told guys, I don't need to know in the newspaper what's going on in heaven. I don't need to learn from the newspaper what's going on in heaven. And what's going on in heaven, where Christ Jesus sits above all other things, hallelujah, is all that's going to matter to change the world around me. And look at how he lived. He stepped into Pentecost at a late age, in his 50s. And look at what, he lived big for God. Come on, people. I want you to come and live big for God. I want you to come on over into this realm. I want you to stand with me, please. Hallelujah. And what I'm going to do tonight, I didn't really go into talking about depression, but I want you to understand this. I want you to understand this. Depression can be where you're afflicted with a disease and you don't seem to be getting out of it. Depression can be where you can't, where it's always you're walking around sorrowful and sad. You always got something berating you in your mind, constantly condemning you, harassing you, tormenting you. Well, tonight in the name of Jesus Christ, I'm going to break off this yoke. Things that are recurrent sin. The Lord wants to strengthen you to when that thing comes at you. That you understand how to receive the strength of the Lord and the power of His might. And you begin to engage. And it is a bit of a struggle, but you know what? The fight will be over soon. Are you listening to me? It's a bit of a struggle. You're in it. You're in a full-on, you know, headlock kind of thing. But I just want you to understand, the angels of the Lord can come minister to you. It's something better than that. So, you know, the angels of the Lord came minister to Jesus. You understand? And he and the Holy Ghost had come upon him, was with him just as much as he's with us. Isn't that glorious? And the angels came minister to him. I'm going to ask you right now, when's the last time you had the angels come minister to you? I want you to understand, we're missing out on some grandiose things in God because we're not willing to press through the things that Satan tries to do to stop the flow of the anointing in our life. I used to be real stupid. I'm just only a little stupid now. I used to be real stupid. Huh? And, you know, I would like, all of a sudden, these things start coming at me. Right, left, and center, from the realms of people, the realms of circumstance, and just, you know, it was like temptation overwhelm you, thing take you over. Usually you didn't, this thing's not even bother you, now it's coming at you, harassing you. You're thinking, my goodness, what happened? God, my God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? And the other night I said, I'm melting. You know? And, I didn't realize that what it was Satan was coming. Satan saw what God was about to do, the purpose and the anointing and the event that was about to take place. And he came out to try to neutralize me, to try to shut down the anointing in my life and the authority in my life by compromising my life, by bringing me under his yoke, by somehow bringing me either under some form of oppression, some form or effect that he could administer that would keep the life and glory of Christ Jesus from being manifest as it would otherwise. It was a glorious day when all of a sudden I became aware of the devices of Satan, no longer ignorant. I said, I know what's getting ready to happen. And you know, one of the things I love about, I love everything about the Holy Ghost. But you give yourself to this place in the Holy Ghost. Holy Spirit will show you when He'll prepare you when you're getting ready to be tempted. And this is for me all the time. You know, I was having a search the other day. I just use a recent example. searching the other day for some specific images that I'm trying to get for finishing up my book. And so I, you know, searched it on the internet. I went into this area because we were looking for a specific picture for the mother of harlots. And of course, that's a bad thing to put in a search engine. Queen of Heaven, Mother Harlots, not suggested. And I mean, I'm over here in this sanctified life. What is sanctified life? Overwhelmed with the glory of God, just like I'm overwhelmed with the glory of God right now. That's sanctified life. Holy Ghost life, sanctified life. It's not a legalistic life. It's life of God life. And all of a sudden, this relationship I have, all of a sudden this particular expression of tongues begin to bubble up out of me. And I know what that is. There is a particular tongues of expression of the Holy Ghost that prepares me for when I'm getting ready to have to face temptation. So you know what I do? I recognize I'm on the wrong page in the wrong site. Shut her down. I already know what's going to happen because I've lived this life out. I've lived out the life of not wanting to be taken out by Satan. I've lived out the life of wanting to overcome every power of darkness. I've lived out the life of wanting to understand what it means to have authority to tread upon scorpions and serpents and over all the power of the enemy. I've lived out the life of wanting to receive the strength of the Lord, the power of His might, so that I can effectively deal with every satanic stronghold and every influence of every angel of darkness, a demonic spirit. And so what happens is the Lord strengthens us and equips us. If we're getting ready to get into a problem or an issue, the Holy Ghost starts making intercession. I go, oh, we're getting ready to face something. Okay. You know what the Holy Ghost is doing when He's giving intercession? He's giving me the ability to be successful at it, to either tell the mountain to get out of the way or the sycamine tree to go get uprooted and planted in the water, to whatever I need. I'm getting prepared to be able to face it and deal with it in the authority of God and the faith and the strength of the Lord. Hallelujah. I want you to have this. I'm telling you, this is what Father has done in my life. I know other people who's done this in their lives, and God's no respecter of person. What you see God do in anyone's life, from Abel to Enoch, anybody in the Bible, anybody in the church at any time, it's available. It's public domain in the kingdom of God. You can have it. God's no respecter of persons. Living the life in the Holy Ghost is the life. It is a totally different kind of life. And it demands major changes in your life. But they're all relationship changes. It's all just enjoying His presence. It's all just spending time with Him and loving it. It's getting up in the morning and saying, Holy Spirit, I want to be so sensitive to You today that I do not miss one, I do not place one step wrong. I'm going to be so sensitive to You. I want to be able to hear You when You want to speak the word of knowledge through me. Hear You when You want to speak the word of wisdom through me. I want to be sensitive, oh God, to say whatever it is that needs to be said to the lost person that I meet, to the folks that I encounter, to those that You want me to encourage. I want to depend upon You to speak everything that I've got to say today, to do everything I've got to do today. I want to live fully for You, Father. I want You to find me a delight and a joy to Your heart this day. Father, I know this is holy and it's sacred, and I get ready and I dance around in the room. Hallelujah. Huh? Come on, baby. Ah, oh, thank You, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hakataya satala mandaya. Uru satamandai kai. Bull satana. And we just tell the Lord, take full control. And we just delight ourselves in it. That's the way it starts. Father's looking for You to give Him permission to bless you. Father's looking for You to give Him permission. You have not because you ask not. When you ask amiss, that you a fantasy that you may consume in your own lust. What happens when you start asking God, God, come take full control of my life. Come live big through me. Oh God, come give me that defense, that strong place in You that Satan cannot touch me, that no temptation will take me, that no oppression will be able to come upon me, that Your river continually flows through me. Oh God, open up doors that no man can shut. Oh God, use me fully for all that You have purposed me to do. I mean, just get after it like that. Amen? Come on. Yeah. And we just live like that. Lord, we're worn out, but refresh us. Hallelujah. It's just like I told you. Get ready because you're getting ready to live big in God.
Hallelujah.
It's just like I told you. Get ready, because you're getting ready to live big in God. Listen to me. The way that Father wants to use you, what Father has planned for this day and this hour, you're going to have to be willing to purify yourself even as He is pure. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and though it does not appear what we shall be, we know that we shall see Him as He is, for we shall be like Him. Everyone who has this confidence purifies himself even as He is pure. Dear evil, God's called us over into a realm of living in the Holy Ghost, living in the fire of His glory. I'm telling you, you're not a wood carving. You're not a hay or straw man. I'm telling you, nothing earthly. Oh, but God's made you something like gold and silver. It's got to be heated up real hot to be shaped to be all that He's purposed. And God knows Tara Nangalea. And God is faithful, who has promised, who shall also bring it to pass. For everybody who's desperate to live fully for God as a representative of heaven, as a person who stands to witness of the resurrection, to show that Christ lives, that He lives right now in me, that He's the glorious King of kings, He's the glorious God Almighty, the King of heaven, far above all principality, far above all power, far above all might, far above all dominions, and He lives in me, and He lives in you. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Taramakos, Tarabobosa. Oh, come have your way! Come have your way! Come have your way, oh God! Come have your way, oh God! Come reveal yourself through me! Come reveal yourself through us, oh God! Come live, oh God! Ha ha! In the fullness of your glory, in the fullness of your power. Oh, Sipadaya Labashabayit. Satarivayolo Kushanayabo Toyolo Mana. It is here in this place that every power of temptation, every power of oppression is broken. Depression will never become a result of your life. You'll never be under a yoke, under the bondage of his slavery. But the anointing would just break off the yoke. You know that verse of scripture, the anointing would break the yoke, the prophets declared, was specifically applied to the Antichrist, the man of sin. But the same is true today. The anointing breaks off the spirit of the powers of darkness, the Antichrist spirit that has positioned itself with such radical force to stop the manifestation of Jesus to the life and the glory of God from being revealed through you and me. But you, dear people, we're carriers of heaven. We're proof providers that Jesus Christ is alive and His authority is real, because His authority is revealed through our lives. I want you to understand that this all begins as you understand how to enjoy His presence. How to just love Him. I tell you right now, I want you to say this again, because I tell people over and over again, I don't need to preach. I don't need to do anything. I have all that I need because I have a place of relationship with Him, and access by the Spirit, an access by faith, by the blood of Jesus. I get to walk into the realms of glory. I've got all that I want over here. It's here in this place that Father sends us out. It's here in this place that our heart becomes enlarged to go, and we begin to cry out, send me, oh God, I'll go. Send me. I see it happening. I see it happening. I see it happening with Claire and Zoe and Jacqueline. I see it happening with all of you. I see it happening with Deborah. And I see such an anointing on Deborah. I saw such an anointing. I've been seeing such an anointing on Deborah Graham. Such a glory upon her life. Oh, Makananea Chana Mombradaya. I see such a glory on Jake. I see such a glory on Josiah. I see such a glory So many opportunities that God has given to Joshua over here. All of you, I could name every one of you. You just got to step in. The more you step in, the greater the radiance of His presence becomes. The stronger the anointing upon your life, the bigger the thing begins to be manifest. The more you give yourself to what God has for you, it begins to be displayed bigger. We can say that we see it. I see it. I could say this about every one of you. I see the call and the gifting of God upon your life, but there's others that I see it now exploding because you've given yourself to it. Hallelujah. I'm telling you. I believe with all of my heart that what's happening right now, no power of hell can stop it. I believe. God has to do this. Understand this. In the complexity of a church, God gives everybody an opportunity. There's many people they want to have it their own way, and they try to turn it with their own opinions, always got their little thing going on. Father has to remove that. And He has to remove it out of our own individual lives. We'll have things going on that are opposing Him. He's got to remove it. He wrestles with it. And when we allow, and the quicker we'll allow Him to do what it is He wants to do and straighten things out, the faster we move into what He's purposed for us to do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Just lift your hands towards heaven. In the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Most High God, I charge you in the name of Jesus Christ to live your life fully for the living God, to be ambassadors of Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, I charge you in the name of Jesus to reveal heaven, to reveal the power and the glory of heaven. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I break the stronghold and the power of every deception and every lie of Satan that has deceived, that has lied to you, that has afflicted or tormented you. In Jesus' name, by the grace of God, you begin to see right now. Caleb, you begin to see right now. You begin to see. Right now, I begin to call back those people who were lost and took wrong turns in the road. I call them back in. People that are your family members, people that are your acquaintance, I call them back in to get right with God, to repent, to come back, to come back, to come back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to understand this. Satan himself, who is the head over all devils and angels, must obey you and me in Christ Jesus. That's power. Paul said to the church at Rome, God will soon crush Satan under your feet. Whoa! That wasn't long when the Roman Empire came down right after that. Oh yeah. Soon God will crush governments and powers under the control of Satan right under your feet. People, it's about time we come over. Stand with the Lord, come out from among them, be separate. Huh. It's about time we start being the heavenly people that God has made us to be, the Holy Ghost people that God has made us to be, with no more compromise. And you watch what's going to come down. You watch what's going to be revealed. You watch what God will manifest through your life. You're going to live out the dream. There's a price to pay. There's a price to pay. But it's every bit worth it. There's a price to pay. To deny yourself. To not live for your own interest. But the price is every bit worth it. Because it's there that Father hones us into a realm of obedience where it becomes all Him and purely Him. And our spirit becomes indistinguishable from His spirit. Our way, our thinking, indistinguishable from His way and His thinking. But that is forged in the fires of temptation where we say no to sin and yes to God. Where we look to the strength of the Lord, we rely upon Him, though we'll die. We'd rather die than commit treason. We'd rather die. You know what? I think the revelation that really came to me that helped me more than anything else was to recognize that all I desired was to do the will of the Father, and recognize that in so doing I had no will. So I gave my will over. That's the only price there is to pay. I don't have a will. I don't have a choice. I don't give myself a choice. I'm dead. My life is hid with God in Christ. And Christ who is my life. When he appears, I'll appear with him in glory. Yeah, and you know what? There's appearings of God all the time. The parousias. When he appears, I'm right there appearing with him in glory. When he's moving, I'm right there moving with him. When the anointing's poured out, I'm right there in the midst of the anointing. Ha! Right in the masate, in the manifest presence of God. Jesus. Mondake shikara mondase. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sizirinana. Sizarinana. Sizaranane. Hallelujah. Sizaranane. Whatever you have need of, just receive it right now. Just be refreshed. Just go ahead and be refreshed. Just go ahead and be blessed. And Father, I just thank you right now, hallelujah, that in every way, your daughter's body adjusts, amen.
Amen.
It adjusts. It adjusts. It adjusts. In the name of Jesus, it adjusts. It adjusts. It adjust. Stomach adjust. Oh, kida no moki chatai. Adjust. Hallelujah. There it is. There it is. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for the great anointing. The Lord just takes a life that surrenders to him. And he makes it a great life and a glorious life. People think, well, you've got to go to school or you've got to do this or achieve that to have a glorious life. No. Rock stars and movie stars and wealthy men and women cannot compare to that which the glory of heaven will do in one yield to the Spirit of God. Bodhiashina. Bodhiashina. Now in Jesus' name. Now in the name of Jesus, this rotator cuff must obey me. Messing with the daughter of the Lord's ability to lift her hand towards heaven. Hallelujah. Okirasande kida monjakai. Elekanamos. Dance more. Dance more. Sutana nea. Halamongea shipane. Lurasatai. Lurasatara mosheya. Halamongea. Hadeyama. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Live big for God. Live big. Live big for him. Moristande. Librostande. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, living God. Robert, come here. I want to pray for you. I can't get to you over there. Father, we want you to take Robert's life and we want you to use him in a big way for you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Would you take him and his wife and bless them, Lord? Father, thank you for opening a door, making a way in Jesus' mighty name. That things will be so well, perfectly organized and established in you. Jesus. 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 Mozada, 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 Mezeda, Mozada, Mozada. We love Robert dearly. Just love him dearly. Kamo Sitaya, Moyashaya. Why? 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 Because of who he is. We love you dearly because of who you are. Hallelujah. Especially the household of faith that you are. And the great call and anointing of God upon your life. Annalyn. The great call of God and anointing upon your life. So see non utikea. Biranan steen. Ziralanan ke. Surasam zolos. Bibade. 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 With your mind, with your heart, with your soul. Filled with the glory, filled with the glory. Elizabeth, I felt the Lord touch your body the other night. Filled with the glory, filled with the glory. Jesus. Ah, look at these GPT. Filled with the glory. Jesus. 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 Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jesus. My God, bless day everything. Jesus, Jesus. Catherine, come here. Jesus, Jesus. Deborah, come here. Just go out there and stand by that microphone. And if the Lord gives you anything, just kind of just sing it out. Just kind of flow. Just either any of them. If you don't have anything, don't worry about it. Just stand there and worship the Lord. Because this is what you're going to do. You're going to start stepping in a whole other dimension. The flowing and the anointing. You know what gets you there? Participating where you're at right now. If you don't participate with the things that God gives you to do where you're at right now, you can never grow mature to Father, what Father wants to develop you in. Huh? Filled with the glory. Filled. Filled, filled with the glory. Just lift your hands towards heaven, Catherine. Filled with the glory. See, that's a wonderful song. I'm filled, filled, I'm filled with the glory. See, that's it. See, you know what I'm doing right now? I'm enjoying the presence of the Lord. This is what I mean by prayer. This is what I mean by going to prayer. And then, you know, I'll be over in here. And then the Lord will hit me with a supplicative prayer. He'll hit me with an intercession prayer. But it's all in the context of enjoying His presence. Huh? Filled. Filled with the glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ah, it's a negation. Yeah. Filled with the glory. Filled with the glory. Oh, so get a number there. Jesus. Jesus. Sandy, you and James, come here. Filled with the glory. Just set her down. Y'all just all stand there together. Lift your hands towards heaven. That's right. Hallelujah. That's right. Gloria a Dios. Filled with the glory. Filled with the glory. Filled with the glory. Filled with glory. Filled with glory. Heather and David, come here. And your family. Heather and David, you're four and a whole lot more. Filled with the glory. Feel the song of the Spirit. Feel the flow of heaven. With an anointing that sets the captives free. With an anointing that breaks the yoke, that brings heaven to men. It causes eyes to be open to see the life that lasts forever. That breaks off every hold of Satan. That releases men from the strongholds of the enemy of their soul. Filled with the glory. Jesus. Filled my unassay. Filled. Filled with the glory. Dance and sing and praise His name and find your life filled up with the King and everything that you desire. All that you have need and want found in this place of enjoying Him. Filled with the glory. Jesus. Jesus. Come here, Bonnie. Filled with the glory, filled up with heaven, from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, filled up with heaven, filled with the glory. Do you know why we lay hands on people? You know why we lay hands on people? So what we have will go into them. That's why Moses laid hands on Joshua. That's why Jesus laid hands on the sick and Paul laid hands on the sick. Because they had divine health and they lay hands on someone, divine health would go into them. We lay hands on people so that they can receive what we have. There's no other reason to lay hands on anyone. Huh? Many times we don't have to because God the Holy Ghost comes to lay hands on you. Amen. Right there where you're standing. Just lift your hands towards heaven. Filled with the glory. Thank you, Jesus. Filled with the glory. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your great blessing and your great provision. Father, everything you gave me, Father, I thank you for giving it to Brad. But everything that you put in my life, Lord, right now, just take it and put it in Brad's life. Jesus. Filled with the glory. Glory of heaven. Glory of heaven. Glory of heaven. Scott, you and Marlene, just come over here. I'm going to pray for you. Especially got to get all these people ready that might be going to Cuba with me, huh? Got to have something to give. Let's answer it. Let God touch you. Flow in a greater dimension of the anointing. Just go ahead and flow in a greater authority in the Holy Ghost. Go ahead and flow in a greater anointing in heaven. Mojaja. 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 Mojaze. 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 Mezezo. Hallelujah. 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 Filled with glory, from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Filled, 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 filled. Filled, 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 filled. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for touching our little sister. Thank you for touching her. Strengthen her little body. Oh, yeah. So filled with the Holy Ghost. Uh-oh. Hold still a second. Hallelujah. Holy is the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Anybody in the house dealing with any sickness or disease in your body? Anybody, if you've got any kind of sickness or disease in your body, just want you to come up here. See the Lord touch you. Any diabetes? Kind of sugar imbalance in your body? Anything? Hello, dear sister. So glad you're here tonight. What you want Jesus to do for you?
I'm having trouble with my knees. I've had them prayed before, and I don't know how it's going to come back, but I'm having a lot of trouble.
What's, is it like arthritis or just?
I've had major falls.
Okay.
And so it's affected the knees.
Okay. Inflammation in the knees. Now, you've been walking with the Lord for a while. And you baptized in the Holy Ghost. Well, you know, sometimes you just got to come right up, stare pain right down in the face. And that's right, and walk around more. Huh? It's true. It is true. So right now, in the name of Jesus, you be strengthened by the Spirit in your inner being. You be strengthened by the Spirit in your inner man. Hallelujah. I'm born to rise up in the faith and the authority of the Holy Ghost and have those things that God has freely given to you by Christ Jesus. Love boasts to take, because the same Spirit that raised Christ Jesus from the dead dwells in you. That's a whole lot of power, a whole lot of authority. Now in Jesus' name, this whole afflicting, tormenting thing gets off of you. I command it so. I command it so in Jesus' name. Just take up with your faith right now. Jesus. Montaya stikiprumsa. Minapla. Minapla. I command this inflammation Go in Jesus' name. I command this pain, go. That your daughter may walk around, hallelujah, and I'm without pain, Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Just let your hands towards heaven. Just receive all this goodness. Just receive. Just recebro tatane. Just recetam blakia. Just recebo taranaya. Just receive a confidence and a thanksgiving and a joy and a celebration. Hallelujah. Oh, masate. Oh, masate morasando no bocana ne angeli bekena. To be able to intercede according to the mind of the Spirit. To be able to romo satayan and makatalo mopaya. To be able to flow in the wonderful realms of the heavenly. In the wonderful realms of Pentecost, that your ears may hear the sounds of heaven. And that Arabositala Makaya Papa will come forth those things like the trumpet blast of glory through your spirit, Masatara, Monglakatai, that prayer become effective in your life, Mosatambra, Mondanda Deapa, that the requesting be made known in such a way that nothing can stop it by the Spirit. Requesting, Borashai, requesting, the request, hallelujah, the request, strengthened, strengthened, strengthened. I said be strong. I said be strengthened. Bata, Mahane. Mahane, Mahananea, 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 Mahana She, Mandea, Monde, Monea Ma, Hey, Maha, Mehea, Mahea, 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 Handari Heshe, Yeah, Manea Toya, Maha, Yeah, Malea, Orisitust, Yeah, Mananga. And just keep going. And do not slow down and do not stop. And let more flow. Modaya. Modaya. Just lift your hands towards heaven. Jesus. John, what do you need? My dear friend. What's up? Oh, healed. Healed. Insulin pump kick in. Brum bum 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 bum. Brum bum bum da 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 da. Like an engine starting up. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
See Toya. Let me show you something. In the Old Testament, the oil, and even in the New Testament, listen to me, listen to me. In the Old Testament, and even in the New Testament, the oil represented the Holy Ghost. Represented the Holy Ghost. And when the Holy Ghost came upon someone, heaven filled their life. And so, when the Lord wanted us to help us understand a little bit about how devils go out of men and how that sickness departs from the body, he showed us, like, for example, in Mark chapter 6, how that they anointed them with oil. In other words, just saying, all it takes is you receiving that which the Holy Ghost is supplying, it comes upon you. So that you might see a, almost as it were like a symbol of what actually God does in the Spirit. And it drives out the sickness and the disease. What drives out the sickness and the disease? Holy Ghost coming on you. It's the power, it's the virtue that flowed out of Jesus. See, a woman broke up, opened a whole nother realm to the miraculous because of what she was willing to do and what she was willing to risk. Because she said within herself, all I must do is touch the hem of his garment and I'll be made perfectly whole. It was after that that all the people around about Gennesaret and around about those areas, suddenly they had this new doctrine. All they need to do is touch the hem of his garment, and as many as did were made whole. And so they besought him that they might touch the hem of his garment. That never happened. That never was heard of until after the woman with the issue of blood did it. She broke open a whole other realm of a miracle supply. And I want you to just believe tonight that you can lay hold on Christ Jesus. You can lay hold on the realms of that which has been supplied to us out of heaven. And you can take up a mantle in God and break open a whole nother realm of access of healing and miracles and signs and wonders to your generation, to the people around you. I'm telling you, I know this. I know there's mantles to be taken up right now. People are just preoccupied and distracted. They're letting Satan hinder them. They're listening to the lies of the enemy that is purposed to stop the anointing and shut it down in your life. When you get that kind of wisdom and insight, suddenly you're not going to allow those thoughts to be in your mind anymore. You're not going to allow those issues to become relevant to you anymore. You're not going to come under those yokes. You're not going to come under those discouragements. You're not going to come under those things like temptation to try to take you away. You say, no, I'm standing here fighting this battle. I'm breaking into a realm. I'm breaking into a realm to see everyone with type 1 diabetes healed. I prayed for a baby in Zambia, missionary's baby, type 1 diabetes, worst kind of case. And the diabetes and the insulin started up. And the sugar level came normal. And everybody was like, whoa, what a miracle. But then all of a sudden, the thing came back. And the family was discouraged, and everybody's like, oh no, you know, we've got to get the baby back on insulin. Well, I'm going to see them again and pray for that baby. I want you to join with me. I want you to take a hold of that which God has for you. I'm telling you right now, when you make what God has for you the most important thing in your life, you will not let anything come and steal that from you. Suddenly you know you've got yourself a fight. You've got yourself a ground to stand on. You know what you're going after. There's a reward you're after. There's something you want. Huh? More than all the other stuff that Satan would try to come and entice you with. I command you to be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, John's got a very terrible case. He's had a very terrible case. I mean, did the Lord heal you? You were healed for a while, weren't you? John, you were healed for a while, right? I mean, it's a serious type 1 diabetes. I mean, angel of the Lord came, appeared to him, and told him about this church. That's how he came to church. It's pretty radical. That's true. Ask him about it sometime. Well, you know what? You're going to walk back in that healing. You just delight yourself in the Lord. Don't get discouraged. Don't get discouraged. Just know in whom you have believed. One of Satan's biggest weapons against us is discouragement, making us feel like we're second choice or second string or on the outs, in the court of the Gentiles. Now you up front, you've got a front row seat in Holy of Holies. Filled with your glory. Sing that a little bit, Deborah, just say, filled with your glory.
Filled with your glory. Filled with your glory.
Say, filled with your glory. Say, I'm filled. That's it. That's it.
I'm filled with your glory, Lord. I'm filled with your glory, Lord. I'm filled with your glory, Lord. I'm filled with your glory, Lord.
Jesus. Now, here's what you do. You just learn how to, every one of you just, you just learn how to flow. Each one of you, I'm talking to each one of you here tonight. You don't force nothing. Just learn how to flow. Sometimes we have to go at it. We have to go at it to break through to the realm. Hallelujah. Huh? Because we won't lay hold on the realm. But then we step in that realm and then we just flow. What do you want? It goes from you now. It goes from you now. I have complete and total authority over that thing. And so do you, and you're going to discover it. I've discovered it, so it's going to work. Mom, come here. How are you feeling now? Jesus. Radamandasi. Stand there with your hands up. Tell you, Lord, touch you. Jess, what do you want? What is it?
Back pain, like in my shoulders.
See your shoulder? Just lift your hands up for a second. Jesus. I command this pain to go out of your body. Jesus. 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 Now. Now. Mananena. Mananena. Yeah, that's right. Just do that for a little while out there. Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Just enjoy His presence. Don't feel obligated. But just enjoy His presence. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Kato sikiyata. Just let the glory of heaven flow up out of your innermost being. Just let the glory of heaven flow right up out of your innermost being. Let the glory of heaven flow right up out of you now. Let the glory of heaven flow. Let the glory of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Yeah. Zero na lamana. Sina na mana nine. Siana na mange. Siana mange. You know, I really believe that God the Holy Ghost would bring you into a place and bring us into a place that this is what church is about. Just worship and praise and flowing in the Holy Ghost. And then as you get lost in the realms of heaven, all of a sudden, various different things, prophecy begins to flow, word of knowledge, miracles, gifts of healing, the working of power of God being displayed. I pray in Jesus' name that you understand that this is so, and that the church is the fullness of Him that fills all things, and that you will give your life, you will give yourself to making the purposes of God and His passion about His church superior to all things in your life. And what Father wants for His church, you're willing to participate with at all cost, at all cost. That a glorious church could be seen in the earth. That the authority of heaven that was there in the first century church that's never gone away would be manifested with greater strength and power in this generation. You have to decide. And I just praise God to see so many of you have made that decision to go get head on, we'll go on the way. Amen. Amen. All the way. All the way, from here, all the way into eternity. From here, all the way into the fullness of the power of the Spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Caught away in Jesus. Caught away in Jesus. Come worship the Lord with your tithes and with your offerings, and find a bunch of people around you, hug them, bless them, tell them that you love them. If there's anybody in here who still wants prayer for anything, you come, we'll pray with you. Father, to touch you. We always have time to pray with you, whatever the case may be, situation may be. Hallelujah.